Yes, a very good morning. We were doing circle chapter and we have done the definition and the terms which are needed to start the chapter. So one theorem yesterday we have done that tangent at any point to a circle is perpendicular to the radius through the point of contact. This theorem is going to be very important. We'll use this theorem in so many questions that tangent to any point is perpendicular to the radius through the point of contact, right? Chaliye. Let us start with exercise 10.1, which is based on the terms and definition we did for this chapter. Exercise 10.1, question number first. How many tangents that a circle can have? How many tangents that a circle can have? How many tangents that a circle can have? You know, we know that for a line to be a tangent to a circle, it should touch the circle exactly at one point. And that one point, that should be on the boundary of the circle. And the circle is collection of infinite many points in the plane. On the boundary of the circle, if we see, there are infinitely many points. So from each and every point, you can draw a tangent to that circle. So we can say that we can draw infinitely many tangents to a circle. So what is the answer of first question? Infinite many tangents can be drawn to a circle, because a circle is having infinitely many points on its boundary. Second question, filling the blanks based on the definitions. First blank is tangent to a circle intersect it exactly in dash point. That is very obvious that when we are talking about a tangent, it always touches a circle exactly at one point. If I say that this line xy is tangent to the circle, then it is very obvious that this line xy, it is going to touch the circle exactly at one point. So what is the answer for the first blank? This is one point, right? Let us start with the second. Second is a line intersecting a circle in two points is called dash. So see, when we are talking about a line which is intersecting a circle, line will be like this. This is intersecting a circle exactly at two points. Let us suppose these points to be A and B. When a line is intersecting a circle exactly at two points, we know the definition. Due to definition, we can say that this line is going to be the secant to the circle, because secant is a line which touches the circle, which meets the circle exactly at two points, right? So the answer for the second blank is secant. Third is, circle can have dash parallel tangents at the most. Students, they got confused in this question. If we see a circle and this is the center of the circle, then these two tangents I can draw parallel to the circle. At the most, two parallel tangents. Why I say that we can draw them in this sense also. But whether you are drawing it in this sense or in the other way, but they two will be parallel to each other. They are not going to parallel to another tangents. So we'll say that to a circle, we can have at most two parallel tangents. Or there are infinite many ways to draw them, we can say. Suppose this is a circle. I can draw the parallel tangents in this way. I can draw the parallel tangents in this way. There are so many ways, infinite many ways to draw them. But there will be only two parallel tangents to the circle at the most, right? So third blank is two parallel tangents. So let us see the fourth one. Fourth is the common point of a tangent to the circle, and the circle is called. When we are drawing a tangent to a circle, then the point which is common to both the tangent and the circle, the point which is both common to the tangent and the circle, we did the definition. This point is called point of contact. This point is called point of contact. So the answer for the fourth blank is point of contact, right? Let us start. This is all about question number second, the filling the blanks. Let us start with question number third. Third question is, a tangent PQ at a point P of a circle of radius 5 cm meets a line through the center O at a point Q so that OQ is equal to 12 cm. In such a big long line, he is explaining the whole statement. Let us see it by drawing the figure. So what he says, we are having a circle. Obviously, we are having a circle. So we have to suppose it center. Let us take O to be the center. A tangent PQ at a point P. So let us take this point P and let us draw a tangent PQ to the circle at this point P. I'm drawing a tangent PQ at a point P to this circle of radius 5 cm. Radius 5 cm. So OP, you know, this OP distance from center to the boundary, it is always known as radius. So OP is radius of the circle. Circle of radius 5 cm meets a line through the center O at a point Q. Meets the line through the center at the point Q. That means this tangent is meeting this line which passes through the center at the point Q. So in other words, you can say this point Q, this is a point of intersection of the line through the center of the circle and the tangent to the circle. So by having this statement, we can draw the figure like this, that PQ is a tangent at a point P and O is the center, where OP is equal to 5 cm is given to be the radius of the circle and OQ is given to be the tangent of the circle. Anshika is not there. Bhavna, you send me the attendance of mass period today. Anshika is not present, I think. Bhavna, am I audible? Okay. Chaliye. So this is the statement, and out of this whole figure, we are given that radius of the circle is 5 cm and the length of this OQ, this is given to be 12 cm. Length of OQ is given to be 12 cm. We want to find the length of this PQ. We want to find the length of this PQ. And you know, it seems to be a triangle. This OPQ, this seems to be a triangle. And in triangle, if two sides are given and the third side is to be find out, then most probably we find it by using Pythagoras theorem. But Pythagoras theorem will be applied. Anshika has come. Anshika, you please send me the attendance. So when we are talking about Pythagoras theorem, we can apply Pythagoras theorem only when we are having angle of 90 degree. So if you see this triangle, you know, one theorem, we did it earlier, that tangent at a point of contact, it is perpendicular to the radius through the point of contact. So if I see this tangent PQ and if I see this radius OP, which is through the point of contact, then I know that this is perpendicular. So you will write directly here, OP is perpendicular to PQ. Without mentioning reason, you can directly write that OP is perpendicular to PQ. Therefore, by Pythagoras theorem, you will be having hypotenuse square, that means OQ square, this is equal to perpendicular square, that means OP square, plus base square, that means PQ square. So this way you are writing. So OQ is 12, so this is 12 square, OP square, that means 5 square, and PQ you want to find, so leave it as it is. 12 square is equal to 5 square plus PQ square. Further, when we will solve it, we will get it to be 144 is equal to 25 plus PQ square. So 144 minus 25 is equal to PQ square. So this will be is equal to Peking square. Is equal to PQ square. Just a minute, wait. So you will be having root 119. The units are given to be in terms of centimeter. So PQ is equal to root 119 centimeter, right? So this is all about this question, that you have to find the length of PQ. Now, these kind of questions can be there when you are given this PQ length and this length of this OQ, tangent length is given, this OQ length is given, you have to find the radius. Sometime radius is given, this OQ is given, you have to find the length of the tangent, and accordingly. Out of these three, you can find one if two are given by using Pythagoras theorem. So, let us start with the next question, question number four. This is just a simple observation. Earlier, this is not in the board exam anytime, but whenever it is, it will be there. You have to draw it using compass and all that, but I'm drawing it roughly. Draw a circle and two lines parallel to given line. First of all, you have to draw a circle with center O. Two lines parallel to a given line. Now you have to take, you have to draw a line. That line can be in any way to the circle, with context to the circle. You have to draw line. I'm drawing a line L. So I'm taking a line L with respect to this circle. And what I need to do, he says, draw two lines parallel to the given line such that one is the tangent to the circle and another is the secant to the circle. So this is the line L. I have to draw two lines parallel to this line L, out of which one is going to be the tangent. Let it be XY, which is tangent to the circle. And this line is having two qualities. Firstly, this is tangent to the circle. And secondly, it's satisfying the given condition. I'm drawing it in such a way that it is parallel to the given line L. Second, you have to draw a line which is known as secant. So I'm drawing PQ. PQ is secant to the circle, touching it exactly at two points. And I'm drawing it in such a way that this PQ is parallel to L. So you can say tangent XY such that XY parallel to L. And secondly, secant PQ such that again PQ is parallel to L. So this way you are drawing one tangent to the circle, which is going to be parallel to the line L, and another secant to the circle, which is going to be parallel to line L. So, you know, after doing 10.1 exercise, you must have realized that whatever definitions we have done till now, that are going to be backbone of this chapter. So you should know the definition of tangent, secant, chord, right? So this will help you in further questions, right? Actually, let us start with the next concept of the chapter. Next concept of the chapter. That is number of tangent from a point to a circle. First case. Suppose I'm having a point P which lies inside the circle. So, and I want to draw tangent from this point P to the circle. You can see that from this point, I will not be able to draw even a single tangent to this circle, because tangent is that line which touches the circle exactly at one point. So if I'm drawing the lines like this, they are going to touch the circle exactly at two points. So if a point P lies inside the circle, if the point lies inside the circle, then no tangent we can draw through that point. Us point se hum circle pe koi bhi tangent draw nahi kar sakte. Second case, let us take the second case. Suppose this point P, it lies on the boundary of the circle. Point inside the circle, and you can say point on the boundary of the circle. on boundary of the circle. If the point lies on the boundary of the circle, then you can see very well that from this point we can draw a single tangent to the circle. Is point se hum circle pe ek hi tangent draw kar sakte hain, that is one tangent. Theek hai, so this is the second case. If point lies on the boundary of the circle, so we can have one tangent to that circle through that point. So if we see the third condition, let us have this circle like this, and point this time I'm taking point outside the circle. So the third case is outside the circle. If the point lies outside the circle and we want to draw tangent to the circle from that point, then you can see that we can draw two tangents. Sorry, we can draw two tangents, say it be PT, say it be PQ, to the circle. So outside the circle, if point lies, then you can have two tangents to the circle. Right? So three conditions are there. If the point lies inside the circle, then no tangent can be drawn. Second case is if it lies on the boundary of the circle, then you can have exactly one tangent. And if the point lies outside the circle, then you can have exactly two tangents through that point to the circle. Right? So these three conditions, they are going to be important. MCQ can be formed from these definition or these assumption, or you can say these observations. So you have to remember it. Now we are going to start with a very important theorem that is based on this third point. We just have realized that if a point P lies outside the circle, then we can draw maximum two tangents to the circle from that point. Now the theorem is based on this observation that if we draw two tangents from a point outside the circle, then the length of the tangents, these two tangents, it's going to be equal. That means tangents drawn from the external point to the circle are always equal in length. This theorem is again going to be very, very important. So let us start with theorem 10.2. Theorem 10.2. Maintain your attendance. I'm telling you, it's going to be very important. Don't get absent without any reason. So please, in all lectures, you have to be present if you want yourself to get marked present in attendance register. So yeah, theorem 10.2. Theorem statement is length of the tangents drawn from an external point, drawn from external point to a circle are equal. This is the statement of the theorem, that length of the tangents drawn from an external point to a circle are equal. This too we have just come to know, that if a point lies externally to the circle, then we can draw two tangents to that circle. And now we have to prove that those two tangents that we have drawn right now, just that, are going to be equal in length. So first of all, I'm going to make the figure of the statement of the theorem. So you have to make one circle, then the center O, and then you have to take a point P outside the circle like this, right? Two tangents are to be drawn from this point P. So let me draw this tangent and another tangent. You know the tangent, it is going to touch the circle exactly at one point. So let us suppose this point to be Q and this point to be R. So this is the figure of the question, that we have taken one external point P and two tangents PQ and another tangent PR. We have drawn from this external point to the circle. So, you know, whenever we are doing theorem, we have to make the figure accordingly. We have to write given, to prove, and then we'll start with the proof. Let us see what is given to us. Given is a circle with center O a point P external to the circle and tangents PQ and PR from P to the circle. This thing is given to us, a circle with center O, external point P, and the two tangents PQ and PR from the point P to the circle, right? What we want to prove, let us see what we want to prove. To prove is that length of these tangents, it's going to be equal. So that means we want to prove that PR is equal to PQ. This we want to prove that PR is equal to PQ. So let us start with the proof. So in 9th standard, we learned one method when we have to prove two parts, two geometrical parts of a figure to be equal. Whenever we have to prove two geometrical parts of a figure to be equal, we keep one thing in mind that we can take the help of congruency. Hum congruency ki help le sakte hain. And one thing more we should remember that whenever we are talking about the concept of congruency, we should have triangle with us, right? So for that, we have to do one construction to get two triangles, of which one is PR is going to be the part and of another PQ is going to be the part. So for that, let us join this OQ and this OR. So even then I'm not going to get a triangle. This becomes a quadrilateral. It becomes ORPQ and it seems to be a quadrilateral having four sides. I need two triangles rather, of which one should be PR. PR should be the part and for another PQ should be the part. So one more modification is to be needed to get two triangles. So what I'm doing, I'm going to join this OP, right? So in this way, let us write this construction point as well, that join OP, OQ and OR. So after doing this construction, it's very much obvious from the figure that we are having two triangles now. One is triangle OPR and another is triangle OP. So let us consider these two triangles. Let us prove their congruency to reach the required result. So I'm taking two triangles, triangle OPR and triangle OPQ. It's very important to write the name of the triangles in such a way such that PN and PQ, they should sit in front of each other, because afterwards we have to prove them to be equal. They should be the corresponding parts of the triangle. So that's why I'm taking them in front of each other. Had it been like ROP and OPQ, then in the end you would not be able to write PR is equal to PQ. So this, so we know in the congruency chapter we did it very minutely, that how to consider the triangle so that the corresponding parts, they can sit one front the other. So we know that to prove the congruency of triangle, we three things are needed. So what are those three things? See, this OP and OP, this is equal to each other and we are writing they are common, right? And as far as this OR and OQ are concerned, they are also going to be equal. OR is equal to OQ. Why so? Being radii of the circle. Radii of the circle always unique. Never vary, it remains constant. So you will have to write that OR is equal to OQ, radius of the circle. Now the third thing, we need three things for congruency. Third thing that we are going to write, that is from the concepts of the definitions and the theorems that we did earlier. The thing is, this is tangent, this is PQ is tangent, and OQ is radius through the point of contact. Again, PR is tangent, and OR is radius to the point of contact. And we did it that a tangent is perpendicular to the radius through point of contact. So if I take this angle to be आप सीधा लिखो एंगल पी क्यू ओ पहले ये वाला ट्राइंगल है तो पहले इसको लो ट्राइंगल सॉरी एंगल पी आर ओ दिस एंगल पी आर ओ इट्स सिटिंग ऑन द थर्ड पोजिशन एंगल पी आर ओ एंड एंगल पी क्यू ओ दिस शुड ऑल्सो सिट एट द थर्ड प्लेस एंड दैट इज सिटिंग ऑन द थर्ड प्लेस दिस इज एंगल पी क्यू ओ सो यू विल राइट 90 डिग्री ईच mentioning the reason as PQ perpendicular to OQ and PR perpendicular to OR. This much reason is sufficient to explain, right? So now three things that are needed for congruency. We have derived those three things. So let us consider the one part and let us see that which rule of congruency is applied here with which we can say that these two triangles, they are congruent. See, this is OP, OR, PRO. This is OP, OR, PRO. So whenever right angle triangle is there, so most probably it is RHS rule. And here it is RHS rule indeed, because 90 degree, one hypotenuse and one side, it indicates that by RHS rule, triangle OPR is congruent to triangle OPQ. Triangle OPR is congruent to triangle OPQ. So both the triangles get congruent. So now by CPCT, you can write that this PR is equal to PQ. So this implies PR is equal to PQ by CPCT. PR is equal to PQ by CPCT. So this was what we want to prove, that tangent through the external point to a circle, they are equal in length. That means they are going to be equal. So I have drawn two tangents from the external point P. One is PR, another is PQ. And we derive the fact that their length, they are going to be equal by proving it. Right? So this is again, its proof is equally important till now as per the information subjective paper. So agar usko hum dhyan mein rakhe, so this theorem, its proof is very important. Many times it is there in board's paper. And moreover, result is equally important because we are going to use this result in so many questions. So both way you have to remember it. Again, you can see there are certain remarks written under this theorem. So these are the another ways to prove this theorem that you can see, but some remarks I have to dictate you, which are related to this theorem. Let us see. Now you see that this triangle OPR, we have proved this is congruent to OPQ. This is congruent to OPQ. So, ये जो आपके सामने ये congruency है, this will lead you to so many results which you will remember. This congruency, it will lead you to so many results which you will remember. See how? Suppose I'm marking them to be angle 1 and this to be angle 2. Let us suppose this to be angle 3. And this to be angle 4. Now see, these two triangles, they are congruent, very much obvious. It is written over here. We have proved it rather. So you can see that this angle 1 of this triangle, is idhar wali side pe wal likho, because humne ye wala triangle pehle liya hua hai. So let us take this to be 3 and this to be 4. So if we see this angle 1 and we see that where it is PRO, it lies on the third part. Sorry, this is angle 1. This lies on the first letter of the triangle. And this angle 2, OPQ, this also lies on the first part, first letter of the triangle. So we know that when the two triangles are congruent, their corresponding parts are equal. So we can easily say that angle 1 is equal to angle 2 by CPCT. CPCT से हमारे पास एंगल 1 एंड एंगल 2 जो है वो इक्वल हो गए. सिमिलरली यू सी दिस एंगल 3 एंड दिस एंगल 4. दिस एंगल 3 इट सिट्स ऑन सेकंड लेटर ऑफ द ट्राइंगल एंड दिस एंगल 4 इन द अदर हैंड ऑल्सो सिटिंग ऑन द सेकंड लेटर ऑफ द अदर ट्राइंगल. दैट मीन्स वी आर हैविंग एंगल 3 इज इक्वल टू एंगल 4. दिस इज अगेन बाय CPCT. So what I want to conclude by dictating this or by explaining it, one result you will remember that line joining the center of the circle to the external point from where the tangents are being drawn, it is going to bisect the angle between the two radii and angle between the two tangents. When I say that this angle 1 is equal to angle 2, that means this line is bisecting the angle between the two radii. Right? When I say that angle 3 is equal to angle 4, it means this line is going to bisect the angle between the two tangents. So these two remarks, you have to remember it by heart because so many times I will use it directly and you should relate that there, that from where the things are coming. So I'm writing the remark. Line joining the center to the external point, to the external point from where the tangents to the circle are drawn. ये हमारी कंडीशन है कि लाइन कैसी होनी चाहिए. ज्वाइनिंग द सेंटर टू द सर्कल ऑफ द सर्कल, सेंटर ऑफ द सर्कल ऑफ द सर्कल टू द एक्सटर्नल पॉइंट फ्रॉम वेयर द रेडियस इज ड्रॉन. लाइन ये वाली होनी चाहिए. क्या करेगी लाइन? विल बाइसेक्ट द एंगल बिटवीन द टू रेडियाई. We'll bisect the angle between the two radii and also between the two tangents. So this is the derived result which we have derived from this theorem, and we will use it in certain questions. So this is all about with today's lecture. Make your notes side by side. Anytime I can call for you for your notebooks. So please do attend your lectures regularly. This is expected from you. Being students of board class, you will not disappoint any of your teacher, and attend your lecture regularly. Okay, goodbye.